The pre-GST sales in the month of June has helped retailers get rid of their old inventory, but it's also led to a slowdown in the month of July. Manufacturers and large trade partners, they've also taken some time to adjust to the new GST regime now. But when we spoke to Kamal Nandi, who is the business head at Godrej Appliances, he seems to be quite positive that the growth is going to come back in August and September. And this because of the festive season demand. There would be aggressive sales there, and there would be a host of new launches as well. Listen in to what he's told BTVi.
So, as you're aware, in appliance industry, the GST rate is 28%, which is higher than the earlier VAT plus excise by about anywhere between 1.5 to 3%, depending on state to state how the VAT was at that point of time. So, obviously, there was a preponement of purchase that we have seen in the month of June by consumers. As a result, and dealers also played it up in terms of giving extra discount to sell out their stocks. So, end of June, we really saw a spurt in demand in the industry, and trade has been able to push out stocks which they were having. Not only more than 1 year old stocks on which they were not giving any getting any input credit, but also the current stocks they have been able to sell out. The purchase during the end of June was low, and we anticipated that it will be low because they were in the process of reducing stock, not increasing stock. Post July, again, we anticipated, post 1st of July, we anticipated that the first month there will be a little bit of, cautious exercise by the trade partners in terms of purchasing stocks. And it'll, over a period of time, as they become more familiar and as the transition becomes smoother, I think the purchases will ramp up. And that's precisely has happened. In the month of July, we have not seen a spurt in purchase. More or less, the primaries will be lower than last year, if I may say so, in the month of July to July, if you compare. Also, the secondaries will be lower, and that was anticipated, because when there was a spurt of end of June, consumer preponed their purchases, we don't expect July to again have a very good secondary sales. So that has happened. So secondary sales will be down in July. Our expectation is to the tune of 15 to 20% down in the month of July. But that will get more than made up in the month of August and September, given that, we are experiencing a good monsoon. There are more incentives in terms of, that we understand there is a hike in HR allowances of central government employees, so that is going to come into the market. I think both these factors is going to help. And also the post-GST ease of business that is going to support overall momentum, overall growth. I think all these three factors will help drive demand, I think, in the month of August, September, and in the festive month of October.
So talking about festive, is there going to be, because of GST, pre-GST sales already, they saw huge discounts. And now that the festive season is so near, are we going to see cut down in the way they are going to be, products are going to be discounted? Anything considering they've already given so much discounts out during the pre-GST sales?
So my expectation is the festive sale would be much more aggressive. Brands will be a little more aggressive in festive, given the fact that the quarter one, because of the whole transition into GST, had its own impact on overall volumes. So industry has not grown in quarter one, and therefore overall June end it has experienced a huge spurt in demand. But if you look at April, May, June together, I think there is no growth in the industry or marginal growth in the industry. So therefore, and we know that this has to be recovered, and the festive is the right I think season for us to recover that lost sales. So we will be aggressive in festive. We will be targeting high growth. About, for example, a brand like Godrej is clearly targeting 30% growth in festive. We have planned a lot of launches during festive, new categories, new segments coming in. So I think all those things will definitely help drive demand.
So now that you've spoken about new categories and segments, give us an idea about what categories and segments and launches are you talking about, your product pipeline?
So we have moved into a new category this year, which is chest freezers. You know, we were a pioneer in refrigeration for 60 years. Largely, we were focusing on the refrigerator, which is a vertical format. Now we have launched into chest freezers because that's a new you know, category which we are finding more consumption. Not only in institution, even domestic consumers have started consuming chest freezers because I think storage of frozen foods are something that is going up and people are adopting those. So that's one new category that we have launched. And the segment we are entering into, front load washing machines. Now that's a segment we have not been present for very long. In festive we are launching that. So we've already launched in Kerala, and now we are going to phase-wise launch it for the in rest of the states.
It's important to understand what Mr. Nandi of Godrej Appliances is saying over there, because in the larger context of the entire consumption theme in our economy picking up, there has not been as much growth as was expected, and now there are the GST pressures that are building up, and of course there is the possibility of ease of business coming in as time moves on, but for the moment those pressures do stand. There are pricing pressures because the markets haven't expanded that much, so pricing and discounting and all of that, and especially the competitive pressures within the entire festive season, all of those are going to play out. But the consumption theme, as most experts point out, remains intact. On that note, we take a very quick breather, but there's much more coming up on the flip side. Do stay with us. We'll be